Oh, right. This, I promise, will be the last video about our recent trip to Davao City. I was offline for a while because when the wife and I came back, we both got sick. And, well, I'm back in the saddle doing my normal stuff. But this was the second night we arrived there. This is in the event center where we live. And they had a get-together, a meet and greet, which was pretty cool because the first night that we arrived, there were Christmas carolers outside the house. And I said, hon, I didn't know they let Christmas carolers in here. And these were not normal Christmas carolers. They were residents. And they were playing music and they were looking for donations because with the donations they get, they'll hold a regular event in the event center for all the residents. And during that time that we met all the residents, I stood up and I talked a little bit about my wife and I and the family and all that. But one of the donations coming up, the money is going to be used for more street lights and for things that the residences come together and vote on to be improved where we live. Oops, let me go turn this back on. Sorry about that. But these are some of the neighbors. Most of them are well-off Filipino families and foreigners. I met some of the foreigners that night. They were all Americans from different parts of the country. And I got called over to a table with a bunch of older Filipino guys. And man, they were pouring me beer after beer after beer. And I don't drink very much, so I had to excuse myself and go back to our table and converse with my wife and my brother-in-law. But this was when we first arrived, and they made some improvements where we live. In case you don't know, it's a gated, guarded community, and they got a dog catcher in there, and they started catching some of the wild dogs. The Filipinos have a different mentality about dogs and cats than we do here in the West, so there were packs of wild dogs in the community, and they used to follow me around and bark at me constantly, and they got a catcher in there and scooped up most of them. But let's see, here's another picture. Okay. Yeah. This is the whole family right here. The young lady next to me there is Ate Tal. Ate means oldest sister, and Tal is her shortened down name from Cristal. You can see she's sitting close to me because I'm hard of hearing. And we would usually go out for dinner and some drinks, and I would ask her if you can sit next to me, because she would terp for me, and she would also tell me what's being said. All I have to do is just say, "Ano? What?" And this is Gary and Beyond. They're the British in my family, and this guy is my brother-in-law and his beautiful wife. He's more of a brother to me than my real brother. I like that guy. He's great. He helps us out so much, even when we're not there. He has durable power of attorney over our home, and making up a list for things to do on our house, which comes into a cultural thing that if you cannot adapt to the culture where you're living overseas, you're not going to make it. Just don't go. Because example is, I want some home improvements done, and it's better that we hire it done for appearances, for appearance sake. It makes you appear as if you're poor if you do your own home improvements, which that's part of the culture that we have to get used to if you want to live in another, you know, especially in Asia. Yeah, I'm making a list for him, for my brother Dagul, right there. He's the guy who made the arrangements at the parking spot, and that was that night that we went out with the whole family and had a night out listening to the Dukes of Davao. But there's Dagul, and that Ate Tal, that's his daughter, and she's single and available, and soon she'll be in the United States as a registered nurse. And I made it clear to her that before you start courting anyone, I'll fly down there, and he has to pass the Uncle Bob interview. And Tal says he might be scared of you, Uncle. And I said, yeah, good. If he's scared and he doesn't meet me, then get away from him. Well, I want you to marry a good man, you know. I told her, no pressure. I don't want you to go thinking that I'm putting you under pressure to get married, but I want you to marry a good man. Here's another picture of that night out that we were at, listening to the Dukes of Davao, and that's Jin Jin and her sister and her mom, and she is expecting their first baby, and that's her husband. But that night we were listening to some headbanging music. This was a young lady who was a headbanger too. And there was one other guy over here at the bar who was a headbanger, and there was a couple way over here by the men's room that were headbangers. There was just so few of us. I had the best time of my life. But one time when I went to the bathroom over there, I come out of the men's room, and there's my longtime friend Ralph standing there. He goes, Bob, Ralph, you know, unexpected meeting with old friends, you know. And he went over to say hi and give regards to the family. And I like Ralph. I respect him a great deal. Let's see. All right, here's that. I showed you that picture here. And the family. Now, this is the rest of the family right here, or part of it. And there's her husband and her mom. And these two young ladies here are the youngest girls in the family. And I'm hoping, or we're planning on, when we get these two through university, that we can go over there and retire, you know. But that's our priority, is to get all the next generation educated, get them through university studies, and so they've got a chance to go abroad and work and have a good life, you know. So that's kind of like almost the end of this video. I do have a list of things to do on our house, and my wife just said, make me up a list and I'll send it to Dagul and he'll handle it, you know. I'm lucky to marry a Filipina that came from a good middle-class family. I really respect these people a great deal, you know. But, yeah, she's my favorite. I shouldn't say that on video. Wife says, don't say that. But she is my favorite because she is so good to my wife and I every time we go there. She's very observant, and I don't even have to ask most of the time. She's right there to help us out, so. Good family. And if you decide to expat to another country, leave your bullshit attitude at home. So, thank you for watching.